And a lot of native New Mexicans living in D.C. and on the East Coast were just as shocked when the quake hit this afternoon. Action 7 News reporter Todd Unger continues our team coverage live from the newsroom. Todd.
Hey there, Tanya. You know, a lot of these people who live in New Mexico or who are New Mexico natives, they no doubt have felt a quake or two around the area. But when you live way out east, it's a whole different story. You local viewer Alex McCormick snapped this photo a little bit earlier today. He was actually near the Interpol building there in downtown Washington, D.C. We actually spoke with other New Mexicans who are visiting and living in the D.C. area. They say the quake at first didn't seem like much of a quake at all and instead reminded everyone of the 10th anniversary of 9/11, which is just a couple of weeks away.
One of the very first thoughts that crossed my mind and the minds of several of my colleagues was, we're under attack again. It was just one of those split second. We looked in each other's eyes and we were thinking the same thing.
I heard people screaming and running down the hallways and stuff, and I opted just to stay still.
That last woman, Denise, they're actually in nearby Wilmington, Delaware, visiting her grandchild who's undergoing cancer treatment. Some very scary moments for everyone at that Ronald McDonald House. Coming up tonight at 6 at 10, we'll have much more on how New Mexicans out east are dealing with this quake. We're live in the newsroom. Todd Unger, KOAT Action 7 News.
And we'll have much more coverage on the East Coast quakes as well as the quakes felt right here in New Mexico coming up tonight at 6.